very adamant, saying, Hagegengo, keep green hydrogen energy clean. I demand from him, keep it clean. And we would look with all eagle's eyes on what will go on, because we are seeing already people lining up on this thing through insider trading, and we are seeing that is not going to be acceptable going forward.
Green hydrogen is one of the most popular sustainable forms of energy that is attracting multi-billion dollar foreign direct investments, according to experts, and it could be the key to lowering the world's carbon footprint, creating thousands of jobs and stimulating economic recovery in countries like Namibia. According to McHenry Vanani, the leader of the official opposition party, there are flickering lights of influential families allegedly queued up to benefit from the project, and he is urging the president to ensure that the green hydrogen procurement processes are transparent and open to all Namibians.
I also want to put a very important matter to the table, and that is to call upon the President of the Republic to keep the hydrogen. There is so much hydrogen demand globally, and Namibia is receiving the necessary attention on the hydrogen as a site that can be able to produce hydrogen. But I want to warn President Gango that if this thing has to really create the necessary job and the economic output that we envisage, then avarice, greed and corruption must stay out of it. We are already hearing flickering lights of people's children lining up to want to do energy proposals, ABCD. We will not allow this huge hydrogen potential to be derailed because of corruption and greed. Procurement processes, both downstream and upstream, should be open. There must be clear tenders, there must be no corruption in this thing, because we have not seen nearly all contracts that went into this country. All of them are marked by murky water of avarice, greed and corruption. So I'm calling upon the government and then President Hagegengo that I put this hydrogen thing on your lap. If you want this thing to be a success, take corruption, take the lining up, take insider trading, take to influential families out of this thing. Let it be open to those capable Namibian companies that can be able to tender both downstream and upstreams and the international bidders, and there should not be money under the table. Let this thing become clean, because I'm very alive to the fact that Namibia is invited for the first time after many years to go and attend the World Economic Forum in Davos early next year. And there is so much world attention on this country, to a point that they are also considering inviting some of us to go and speak about corruption and so forth. So what we are saying is that Namibia, we are a great country, but corruption has taken us down. Government is pretending not to be God, so don't be the God of corruption. Open up the procurement processes, make sure that everybody benefit in this thing in a very fair and transparent manner, taking our country socio-economic trajectory forward.
Green hydrogen is created using electricity supplied from renewable energy sources like wind and solar, and it can be utilized in industrial operations like fertilizer production, as well as oil and gas refineries and automotive applications. President Hagegengo, at his recent launch of the second phase of the Harambe Prosperity Plan, expressed that the HPP2 plans to investigate the feasibility of green hydrogen and ammonia production as a transformative strategic industry for Namibia's economic advancement. According to preliminary estimates, Namibia's potential for low-cost green hydrogen energy production could bring in over $9 billion in foreign direct investment and create about 15,000 direct jobs in the market.